بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This surah, the explanation of surah An-Naba, تفسير سورة النبأ. سورة النبأ, the translation of the meaning is the great news. The great news. And it is the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which calls mankind to the belief in Tawheed, in the oneness of Allah, and informs about death and resurrection. The disbelievers disputed about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the message that was revealed to him. They questioned, what is the recitation, meaning of the Quran? Where did he bring this Quran? Some said it is magic, others said it is poetry, and some considered it stories of the past. They asked each other many questions, including questions about the day of reckoning. And Allah revealed this surah starting with عَمَّ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. What are they asking one another? عَنِ النَّبَإِ الْعَظِيمِ, about the great news. So the disbelievers questioned the occurrence of the day of reckoning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one most high, free of all imperfection, describes this day as the one that brings great news. Naam. Describes this day as the one that brings great news. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, the eminent scholar and al-hafidh and mufassir rahimahullah, said that most likely this news refers to the resurrection after death, based on the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about it in the next verse, that comes verse 3, الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ مُخْتَلِفُونَ, about which they are in disagreement, about which they are in disagreement. Mankind are divided to believers and disbelievers regarding the occurrence of this day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns those who deny it by saying in the verse that comes, verse 4, كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ, nay, they will come to know. ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ, nay, again, they will come to know. An emphasized and a confirmed warning for those who deny this day, that they will certainly come to know that the day, this day of resurrection, is true. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows His abilities to produce the signs of this day, and He tells about its magnitude in the following verses, so that people contemplate and realize that Allah, who is able to bring about these signs, is also able to bring life to the dead as well as resurrection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells mankind about many aspects of His ability and power to create what He wishes. For those who underestimate Allah and His greatness, there is a reminder. And for those who believe, there is an affirmation. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا. That's why he says, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا. Have we not made the earth as a bed? He, Allah, made it suitable and stable for mankind, so that they benefit from it, from this earth we live on. وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا, and the mountains as pegs, to provide cohesiveness and stability to the earth. Modern scientific discoveries found that these pegs are driven into the ground like pegs used to anchor a tent. وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا, and we have created you in pairs. You see how the signs, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exposing mankind to his signs. وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا, and we have created you in pairs, males and females, tall and short, good and bad, etc. Males and females lawfully enjoy each other through marriage and have children. This enjoyment is physical as well as emotional. It provides mercy and morally abiding friendship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse in the Quran, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, as in chapter 30 verse 21, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. As in Surah Al-Rum, and among his signs is this, that he created for you wives from among yourselves, that you may find repose in them, and he has put between them affection and mercy. Verily in that are indeed signs for people who reflect. Then Allah continues talking about his signs. وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا, and have made your sleep as a thing for rest. Sleep discontinues the motion at the end of the day, a resting time for human efforts seeking sustenance. This is just one other mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا, more. وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا, and have made the night as a covering through its darkness. The darkness cover you just as your garment covers your body. The covering night produces a quiet environment to reside in and to become still. وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا, and have made the day for livelihood. Allah produced shining light in it from the sun, so that people can manage their affairs and function to produce their livelihood, which He subhanahu wa ta'ala had already ordained for each individual in appropriate measures. In another verse we read, as in Surah Al-Qasas, chapter 28, verse 73, وَمِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ جَعَلَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لِتَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ وَلِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. It is out of His mercy that He has put for you night and day, that you may rest therein, meaning during the night, and that you may seek of His bounty, that is during the day, and in order that you may be grateful, that you may be grateful. Who other than the Creator of the day and night can balance these respective courses of time? قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِضِيَاءٍ أَفَلَا تَسْمَعُونَ. الله أكبر. Say, O Muhammad, tell me, if Allah made night continuous for you till the day of resurrection, who is a God besides Allah who could bring you light? Will you not then hear? قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, tell me, if Allah made day continuous for you till the day of resurrection, who is a God besides Allah who could bring you night wherein you rest? Will you not then see? Then more of the signs. وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا, and we have built above you seven strong heavens, seven wide high, firmly constructed, beautifully built, without supporting columns, beautified with stars, planets, the sun and the moon, the sun as a shining lamp. وَجَعَلْنَا سِرَاجًا وَهَاجًا, and have made therein a shining lamp. But we take these things for granted. Like, how many of us, you know, during the day contemplate these matters? And have made therein a shining lamp. This lamp, quote unquote, illuminates the whole universe to provide light as well as heat, allowing growth and energy production and so forth. وَأَنْزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ مَاءً ثَجَّاجًا, and we have sent down from the rainy clouds abundant water. Allah beautifully explains in another verse in Surah Ar-Rum in chapter 30, verse 48. الله الذي يرسل الرياح فتثير سحابا فيبسطه في السماء كيف يشاء ويجعله كسفا فترى الودق يخرج من خلاله فإذا أصاب به من يشاء من عباده إذا هم يستبشرون. Allah is He who sends the winds so they raise clouds and spread them along the sky as He wills, and then break them into fragments until you see rain drops come forth from their midst. Then when He has made them fall on whom of His slaves as He will, lo, they rejoice. The benefits of water are remarkable. That's why He said right after that, لِنُخْرِجَ بِهِ حَبًّا وَنَبَاتًا, that we may produce therewith corn and vegetations, eaten by man and animals, and used in various useful means. Not only that, وَجَنَّاتٍ أَلْفَافًا, the next verse, and gardens of thick growth, with different fruits, fragrance, tastes, smells, produced in one single piece of land, irrigated by the same source, and that is water. One thing, spreading to all of these fruits and vegetations, all with different colors and fragrance and taste and so forth, yet watered with the same type of water, with water, just all. And this is similar to another ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي الْأَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ وَجَنَّاتٌ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَزَرْعٌ وَنَخِيلٌ صِنْوَانٌ وَغَيْرُ صِنْوَانٌ يُسْقَى بِمَاءٍ وَاحِدٍ وَنُفَضِّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ. And in the earth are neighboring tracts. Surah Ar-Ra'd, verse 4. And in the earth are neighboring tracts and gardens of vines and fields sown with corn and palm trees, growing out two or three from a single stem root, or otherwise one stem root for every palm, watered with the same water. Watered with the same water, yet some of them we make more excellent than others to eat. Verily in these things there are signs, proofs, evidences, lessons for the people who understand. All of these favors of Allah mentioned are so vivid. How could the disbelievers make use of all of these bounties and yet deny the resurrection and deny the resurrection? Then comes the realities. O man, don't forget that there is an appointed term for everything. Man, don't forget that there is an appointed term for everything. إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْفَصْلِ كَانَ مِيقَاتًا. Verily the day of decision is a fixed time. This time does not increase, nor it decreases, or it is to be postponed. And no one knows its specific occurrence except Allah, who says about it, يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَتَأْتُونَ أَفْوَاجًا. The day when the trumpet will be blown, and you shall come forth in crowds, in groups. Each ummah, each nation, will come with its respective imams or leaders, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse in the Quran, in Surah Al-Isra, chapter 17, verse 71. يوم ندعو كل أناس بإمامهم. And remember the day when we shall call together all human beings with their respective imams, their prophets or their holy books like the Quran, the Torah, the Gospel, or the records of good and bad deeds, or the leaders, etc. In fact, in the hadith which the Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah relates, that Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him, said that the Prophet ﷺ said, quote, between the two sounds of the trumpet, there will be 40. 40. Somebody asked Abu Hurairah, 40 days? But he refused to reply. Then he asked, 40 months? He refused to reply. Abu Hurairah added, then, after this period, Allah will send water from the sky, and then the dead bodies will grow like vegetation grows. There is nothing of the human body that does not decay except one bone, that is the little bone at the end of the cossacks, of which the human body will be recreated on the day of resurrection. So the day when the trumpet will be blown, and after that, وَفُتِحَتِ السَّمَاءُ فَكَانَتْ أَبْوَابًا, and the heaven shall be opened, and it will become as gates, allowing the passage of descending angels. وَسُيِّرَتِ الْجِبَالُ فَكَانَتْ سَرَابًا, and the mountains shall be moved away from their places, and they will be as if they were a mirage. And this is similar to the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another ayah of the Quran. As you know, the Quran explains the Quran. وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ صُنْعَ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَتْقَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ إِنَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَفْعَلُونَ. And as in Surah An-Naml 27 verse 88, and you will see the mountains and think them solid, but they shall pass away as the passing away of the clouds. The work of Allah, who perfected all things, verily He is all acquainted with that what you do. ويسألونك عن الجبال فقل ينسفها ربي نسفا. And they ask you concerning the mountains. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my Rabb, my Lord, will blast them and scatter them as particles of dust. As in Surah Taha, chapter 105. And in Surah Al-Kahf, وَيَوْمَ نُسَيِّرُ الْجِبَالَ وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ بَارِزَةً وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. And the day we shall cause the mountains to pass away like clouds of dust, and you will see the earth as a leveled plain, and we shall gather them all together so as to leave not one of them behind. People think when they see the mountains that it mounts to something, yet it is nothing, and it will completely vanish without any remains. Then there is the distinction. There comes then the distinction. Inna jahannama kanat mirsada. Truly hell is a place of ambush. للطاغين. To whom? للطاغين مآبا, a dwelling place for الطاغين. الطاغين, those who transgress the boundary limits set by Allah, like the kuffar, the disbelievers, the mushriks, worshipping other than Allah, the hypocrites, the sinners, the criminals. لابثين فيها أحقابا, they will abide therein, أحقابا, meaning for ages, one after the other, forever, as related by Qatada and Al-Hasan al-Basri and other prominent scholars of the Salaf. Most of them mentioned that each haqb is 80 years. Concerning, of course, the disobedient Muslims, the sinners who may be punished in the fire of hell, then this is not forever. Because every muwahid, everyone who says La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah and does not bring in his life something will be in direct opposition to this, that will nullify this declaration, then his final abode is paradise. لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا ولا شرابا, nothing cool shall they taste therein, nor any drink. No cooling of their hearts, no cooling shall they find in hell, nor a good drink to quit their thirst. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِلَّا حَمِيمًا وَغَسَّاقًا, except boiling water and dirty wound discharges like pus and stuff like that. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. The dark fluid is a festering water from the sweat, tears and wounds of the people of hell. جزاء وفاقا, عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته, KH. An exact recompense according to their evil crimes. And Allah is the most just. His punishment is all just. They will be punished because إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا لَا يَرْجُونَ حِسَابًا, for verily they used not to look for a reckoning. They didn't believe that everything will return to Allah, and therefore they didn't prepare for this day. وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا كِذَّابًا, but they belied our ayat, our signs, our proofs, our evidences completely. They belied the revelations together with the guidance shown to them by Allah's messengers. All the messengers they faced with rejection and denial. But everything is in a written book. وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ كِتَابًا, and all things we have recorded in a book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had known all the deeds of his slaves and had written them all in a book long before mankind was created. He decreed reward and punishment, and that there is no sin more grave than shirk, than setting up rivals with Allah in worship. Those who commit shirk have an ill opinion about Allah, and justly they shall receive an eternal punishment, and that is hell. فَذُوقُوا فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ إِلَّا عَذَابًا, so taste you the results of your evil actions, no increase shall we give you except in torment. It will be said to the people of hell, taste what you are suffering. We shall not grant you an increase except similar torment, and so it shall progressively multiply. It is related that Abdullah bin Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, and his father said, Allah did not bring down on the people of fire an ayah, a verse more severe than this verse which I just recited. فَذُوقُوا فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ إِلَّا عَذَابًا, so taste the results of your evil actions, no increase shall we give you except in torment. He said, they will be forever in a state of progressive increase in torment. and Allah is most just. عليكم السلام.